being the full text of speech delivered by the National Democratic Front, NDF, on the State of the Nation press conference addressed in Abuja on Monday, February 22, 2021. Protocols. Gentlemen of the press, you are aware that a coalition made of 43 groups has come out to demand that President Muhammadu Buhari steps down or be impeached by the National Assembly if he does not meet their five-point demand. The basis for this seditious demand is the security breaches in the country, which these groups are claiming that the president has not done anything about. Without meaning to promote the propaganda that these elements have deployed against the nation, we will repeat their demands here, just we are able to specifically speak to them. Number one, provide political and moral leadership for the security crisis and ensure governmental actions are humane in tandem with Section 17, subsection 2C of the Constitution. Number two, end impunity for abuse of power and sanctionalism through its appointment by balancing the need for competence with the federal character principle. In this way, it will demonstrate that every part of Nigeria matters as national appointments appear to fuel sectional violence. Number three, take responsibility and end the persecution of the media and free speech, both of which are foundations of a democratic state. Number four, mobilize our rich Nigerian assets to address the insecurity situation across the country and seek international cooperation to ramp up security assets. Number five, where the president fails to fulfill his constitutional duties as stated above, we demand he steps aside or the National Assembly initiates impeachment proceedings against him on grounds of gross misconduct as provided for in Section 143 of the 1999 Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Before proceeding to speak on these demands, we will first speak on the identity of those making them so that Nigerians can appreciate that they are being taken for a ride by a criminal gang that has remained dissatisfied from the moment their sources of slush and illicit funds were obstructed by the reforms bettered by the President Muhammadu Buhari. The coalition is an assortment of groups with several interests that have been packaged to appear as being in the best interest of Nigerians, but in reality are a danger to the entire country. Number one, the coalition is apparently led in part by Civil Society Legislative Advocacy Center, CISLAC, whose head, Awal Musa Rafsanjani, is a board member of Amnesty International and Transparency International, two organizations that are obsessed with confirming Nigeria as a failed state. These are organizations that have invested much in supporting Boko Haram and just any terrorist organization that can help create a sense of terror and insecurity. It is now apparent that the entire support that Amnesty International and Transparency International has been offering to terrorists was meant to culminate in the Nigeria assets. Rafsanjani leading a charge to overthrow the government of President Buhari through a coup by the legislature, which has infiltrated with CSLAC that has been gathering blackmail materials on federal lawmakers. Number two, Social Economic Rights and Accountability Project, SERAP, is another of the NGOs that has, over the past few years, invested a lot of resources to demarcate the government of the day by constantly raising false alarms based on unsubstantiated claims. Its strategy has been to distract the government from functioning using spurious litigations and court cases that have never been pursued to conclusion. Why this group is asking for the president to mobilize our rich Nigerian assets to address insecurity situation across the country and seek international cooperation to ramp up security assets, they are doing the exact opposite in contributing to precipitate the security situation in the country. Mr. President has been working hard to address the security situation while it is apparent that some people are out to jeopardize his efforts. Nigerians have been wondering who these people are, which makes it a good thing that this coalition has exposed itself as part of those that have been undermining the country's security for their own selfish end. Consequently, the coalition's demand that where the president fails to fulfill his constitutional duties as stated above, we demand he steps aside or the National Assembly initiates impeachment proceedings against him on grounds of gross misconduct as provided for in Section 143 of the 1999 Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria is one of that Nigerians should hold them accountable for. It is a subtle threat and an exposure of their plan to overthrow the government in any way possible. The Nigerian Democratic Front, NDF, hereby alerts Nigeria to the uncovering of the plot by the coalition to facilitate further degeneration of the security situation in the country, which they will then use to launch a Buhari must go protest across the nation. We want Nigerians and the international community to hold every single group and individual in the coalition responsible for any resulting degeneration in the security situation in the land. We ask the law enforcement agencies to be alert, especially with the discovery that the coalition is reportedly working on multiple options for destabilizing the country further in order to force the president out of office. This is a dangerous threat to our democracy and must not be allowed.